Welcome to Our Green Acres. I'm Teresa. In today's video, I'm going to bring y'all along. I'm going to show you how we can make a very inexpensive farmhouse tray using a Dollar Tree product and some textured paint. I'm also going to take you along through the video and I'm going to show you how we can make some really inexpensive items to display on our tray. I'm going to show you how we can make some really cute beaded garland, and I'm going to take a piece of scrap wood and show you a really cute idea for spring or summer decor. So I hope y'all enjoy the video and I hope y'all get lots of inspiration. If you haven't joined my Facebook home decor page, I'd love for you to go over and join it, and also go over and follow me on Pinterest and Instagram. Okay, for the first project, I'm going to show y'all how we're going to take a Dollar Tree tray, or you can probably get a tray anywhere at a dollar store, Dollar General, you know, whatever you have. It's just a plastic tray. It's pretty large. I guess this is what you call a platter. And we're just going to take it, and I showed in a couple of videos of how I started using the textured paint. It's the big trend right now, and I wanted to try it. So I do have a video on another thing that I transformed with a textured paint, but I'm just going to show you how easy it is. You can take any kind of paint. You use acrylic paint, craft paint. I've got a little bit of mineral chalk paint left in this bottle, so I'm just eyeballing my baking soda. But basically, you just want to add baking soda to your paint. And I'm going to leave the recipe down below. But I'm just eyeballing this since I just had a piece of a bottle, and you want it to be pretty thick. Now, the first layer that I'm going to put on the tray, and as you can see, I took the tray out and I sprayed it down with some primer. I felt like that way my paint would stick to that plastic a little bit better, so, or acrylic, whatever that little tray was made out of. But anyway, I sprayed it down with some Rust-Oleum white primer, and then I'm going over it right now, and I'm not dabbing it on yet. I will when I go for my second or my third layer, but I just kind of brush it on. I left that dry really good, and that's the key. You want to let it dry really good in between your layers. Next, I'm going to take this chippy brush, and I have this brush linked to my Amazon store under craft supplies if you're interested and you know and you need one. And I'm just taking it, and now I'm dabbing it on, and that baking soda in that chalk paint just really, in just a minute you're going to see when it dries what it does. It just really comes together, and you would never know this was a plastic dollar store item. So this is where, after I got all my layers, I think I did two layers. It didn't take a lot with that primer on it. I think I did two layers, and you can see as it's wet what it looks like. And then I'm going to show you in just a second what it looks like. This is what it looks like once it dried. Is that not amazing? I mean, like I say, you could never tell that was a pink plastic platter up under there. But anyway, so for $1, and like I say, you don't have to use chalk paint. You can use any kind of, you know, the 50-cent craft paint at Walmart, whatever you have on hand to make it inexpensive. So next, you know, we can't make a tray unless we have some beaded garland to go with it. And now I made a video, I don't know, a few videos back of a beaded garland that I made with these Amazon beads. And I'll have them linked in my store. And I'm just going to repurpose them. So I've already strung them on some wire twine, and I'm going to go over them. Now this is some white textured paint that I made a few videos back. And I just put it in a airtight container, and I'm just reusing it because I've already got it mixed up. So I just took it back out, and I thought I'm going to use some textured paint on these beads and see how this turns out. So I just go over my beads the same way I did the tray. I go over them, you know, with a few layers, however much it takes. Now to make some tassels for the end, I'm going to use some Dollar Tree yarn. Y'all, I love this yarn. I just picked it up recently, but it's cotton, and it makes really good tassels for the beaded garland. So I took a cereal box, and I measured out about the size of four of my fingers for the height of this. And I'm just going to go around it about 60 times. And that way it will keep your yarn uniform, and when you pull it off, all your loops should be about the same size. Because sometimes when you wrap it around your hand, you'll get some tighter and you'll get some looser. To me, this was easier to wrap it around the little little cardboard box. And then once you get them all, you know, wrapped around, you want to take it off and you want to keep, you know, keep it all looped up. And you want to take a strand of yarn and you want to tie it really tight at the top in a knot. Now, I am not going to wrap around the top like a lot of tassels do. I'm going to just leave mine with that one tie at the top. Now, you want to go in, you want to cut your bottom. And then once you get your bottom cut, then you want to comb through it. Just make sure you've got all your ends down at the bottom. And once you comb it through, just hold it really tight at the bottom. And then you're just going to want to go in, you know, and trim it up. Give it a really good little haircut where your bottom is all even. And then once you get it done like that, then I just brush through it again. Give it another little haircut. This makes the cutest, fluffiest little tassel. I love this. Now, I'm going to put something different on one of the other ends, but I'm going to show you how I attach that tassel. You know, at the end of my beaded garland on that wire twine, I had a knot. So I'm just going to take those long strands that I tied at the knot of my tassel, and I'm just going to wrap those around that little knotted end, and I'm just going to wrap it until I get to the end of the twine, the yarn, and then once I do, I'm just going to secure it with a little bit of hot glue on the back, and that's all you have to do to attach your tassel. But I'm going to use a little Target Dollar Spot little, I got this, I don't know, a couple years ago. It was like a little gardening theme, and it's just a little metal plaque. Anyway, I just kind of want to add something a little bit different, give y'all a little bit more ideas of things you can add to beaded garland besides tassels. And here it is, paired with the tray. I think it turned out really cute. And never forget about other products at Dollar Tree that you may not think about that makes great staging items for your spaces, and that's sunglasses. I picked these little cute sunglasses up at Dollar Tree. So just another little idea when you're decorating your spaces for spring and summer, look through the sunglass section at Dollar Tree. I just wanna love you, just wanna hold you, just wanna be with you till we grow old. Please tell me you'll stay or take me away. I want you for myself every single day. You set my world on fire. You set my world on fire. All right, now I'm going to show you another item that we can make to display on this tray, and that's going to be a thrift flip. And I purchased this just like this at a thrift store for $1. Now, I'm going to take the twine off of it, and evidently somebody, you know, they painted it orange and they distressed it around with some brown. It looks like stain or a marker, but I'm not real sure. But the back of it has got a pretty good base as far as the wood, so I'm going to go with that side. But I did my candle wax method, which I use in a lot of my videos. And so if you're not familiar with it, you know, I do it in most of my videos. So I've distressed it with my candle wax method. I chalk painted it with white linen. And then I'm going to take a cute little truck, and I'm going to link this truck below. It's a free printable that I got off of a website, and I just cut it out. And I love the little truck with the flowers in it. I thought that screamed spring and summer to me. And then I just got some Mod Podge. I applied it on the back, and now I'm just applying it to my scrap wood. And then I'm just going to show you different ways that we can embellish this. And again, you know, Dollar Tree products, you know, I'm going to give you an idea of things that you may not look for. You know, instead of ribbons and laces, look in the hair accessory section at Dollar Tree. They have some really good embellishments for your craft projects. These are little headbands, and it was funny, these little headbands, I picked them up because I thought they looked kind of like lace, but they fit just perfect around my square block. So I'm showing you just about all of these colors would work with my little truck. Because there was a pink one, a blue one, and a gray one. So you could put this on there, then you can embellish in the corner with a messy bow. I'm showing you here, this is just a piece of lace. You just tie it in a knot, and you've got that little knot in the center, and just a little piece of flower. Now I'm going to go with a big poofy bow on the top. So I just made a looped bow, and y'all know when I make my loop bows, I usually do about 3 loops, and then I'm going to leave that twine because I like that little rustic look to go with the little truck, and I'm going to end up fraying it at the end, and y'all will see when I stage it. And then I'm just going to get a little flower, and I think I picked these up at Walmart. Very inexpensive. And there you go. And I'm going to end up trimming the twine and fraying the ends. I don't know what I'd do without you. You make me smile. What is it that you do? My life was great till you added colors. Like the moon is the snow. We don't care about the just wanna love you, just wanna hold you, just wanna be with you till we grow old. You tell me you'll stay or take me away. I want you for myself every single day. If you like this video so far, I hope you'll hit that like button. And also, if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, I'd love for you to. I just need you. I don't know what it is you do. I just want you. I just need you. I want to share with y'all, I want to give y'all just another little idea for a little bunny I made a couple videos ago, and I'm going to link that video down below. But I watched a Facebook Live last night that Totally Dazzle did. And if y'all are not following Totally Dazzle on Facebook, please go over and follow them, because she did a great live last night. She made a wood bunny, and it was kind of like the one I made, but she painted hers gold, and she put a messy bow on it, and she showed all the mini products that Totally Dazzle offers that you can embellish that little bunny with. And it just gave me a great idea for my bunny. You know, she was very creative with all the little embellishments and showed different ways of how you can just really bump up your Easter decor. And she even actually, on the Facebook Live, she did a big egg also. So like I say, make sure to go over for more inspiration and follow them. I'm going to leave all their information down in my description box, also with a link if you want to go out and shop their website. And I'm going to be uploading a new video on Monday with a big collaboration that I'm doing with some other great YouTube creators. So I hope y'all stay tuned for that. So I will see y'all again on Monday. Love y'all, and thanks so much for watching.